How's it going, guys? Dre here, and welcome back to another episode of the Best Besiege Creations. This week, we're starting off with something that I've never seen before. This is called Hammerfoot, and it is a vanilla sweeper-propelled hovercraft. So it's working like other hovercrafts, but it's actually using spinning plates to use it as a weapon as well. So obviously, this thing's bomb-proof, it's soldier-proof, and it's also fireproof because it's made out of all metal, so it really is one rigid design. I also want to see how fast this thing is because I've never saw something work like this before. You can see how it turns. It just slightly leans the sides, and then to go forward, it leans both sides out. So let's go around. There's a bunch of soldiers over there. We're going to pay a visit in a little bit, but let's go around first just to see how fast we can go with this thing. And it's going a decent speed at about 136 right now. Now, also, you're supposed to be able to take this thing off-road, and as you can see there, it actually did quite good. Yes, this is a dead end over here. So let's, you know what? Let's just try it just to see what happens. And you can see it didn't actually break it. So this is a rock-hard design. I actually want to see how good this would be off-roading. But before we go do that, let's go do what this thing's made to do, and that is destroy a few soldiers. So they're not supposed to be able to get in here at all, and yeah, as you can see, it's actually really, I think I just damaged myself there. It's actually really hard to drive when all these things are being hit by it, though. But as you can see, it's doing exactly what it's meant to do, which is destroy everybody. How are we doing for damage here? Let's pull back a little bit. I know I did lose a few parts, but I think this thing's still more or less perfect. Yeah, you can see the bottom. It's actually really impressive how well this thing stays together. This is not an invincibility, by the way. All right, see you later, buddy. We still got quite a few over here. The one hard thing with this is it's not the easiest to drive, which isn't surprising. I mean, it's running on spinning frictionless frames, so yeah, it does drive very similar to, like, an airboat. All right, but we're gonna take out some of these guys. Yeah, there's no way they're gonna be able to destroy me. There's nothing that can destroy me here, so I am quite literally invincible unless I crash into something myself. Now, what I'm more curious about, we saw how good it was off-roading. Let's see how good it is in the Gobi Desert, one of the roughest terrains in this game. Okay, it's a little bouncy. I think it's gonna be a pretty rigid ride, but okay, so we did lose a piece there. That's not good. Let's see how long it takes to destroy this thing. I thought it'd be a little bit better, admittedly, but, well, we still haven't really seen it shine, so, oh, God. This is actually amazing that it can do this, though. You think it would just implode on, you know, the hits, but no, somehow this thing can stay together. Not the most fast or best off-roader, that's for sure, but this thing should not even be able to be taken off-road, so I think that's pretty cool. All right, and we got another Transformer, ladies and gentlemen. This is obviously Bumblebee. Now, this is actually made by a new creator, or rather new creator. If you remember the waifu from maybe last week, maybe the week before. But yeah, the waifu in Besiege, which was actually really, really impressive. Well, this is the same creator, and he decided to build a Transformer this time. So, we got the Bumblebee in car form. It looks really, really impressive. Like, you could hardly tell this is a Transformer, aside from obviously some spaces in the paneling. Not the fastest of cars, going at a stable 36 kilometers an hour, but you know what? Let's just pretend it's a Rolls Royce, because it kind of looks like one and acts like one. But the fun part of a Transformer is transforming, so let's slow this down and see if this guy is good at making Transformers, because it's been a while since we've seen one. Oh yeah, that feels good. And there he is, popping up. We got Bumblebee, ladies and gentlemen. How fast was that? Because that was going really slow. So let's go back down. Wow, that... I gotta say, that's one impressive transformation. A few panels are not in their position, but aside from that, I mean, that is just perfect, and that is amazing. Now, there is a lot we can do with this guy. He is a walker as well, so... Okay, cut... Let me rephrase that. He's a drunk walker, because actually it's not that bad. He looks like he has to take a poop or something. He's got something between his legs. Oh, that sounded wrong. There's gonna be some interesting jokes in the comments, that's for sure. But this guy's got some interesting stuff. So a lot of animation, just like the waifu, you can do a lot of this stuff. Whoa, I don't know what he's doing. Almost looks like he's trying to learn how to dive into a pool. Anyways, that's how I was trained to, move my arms when I wanted to dive in the pool. But as you can see, the animations for the arms and everything, pretty impressive. But what I'm more curious about is this guy can cry and he can pee. Yes, you heard that right. All right, let's try crying. Okay, he's literally... That's a lot of water, man. And where are these things coming out? Okay, so that's just sad. Now, I'm more curious. Yes, he can pee as well, guys. Amazing. All right, this has been a long time coming, you little jerks. I've always wanted to pee on you, and now I can. So get out of here. That's right. Take my pee to the face. Oh, man. Only in Besiege can you get something as amazing as this creation and have a pee function with it. All right. Oh, I was hoping to land on some of them. Whoa, you guys are being aggressive. All right, I'm out of here. Taking your houses with me. Peace. I can't even. This car is so slow. I can't run over the opposition. That's all right. At least I can get out of here. And moving on, we have a very large missile. This is the Russian Topol M. No, it is not a penis. This is indeed a missile. And we're going to launch this thing. I love how this thing is literally the size of the castle. So... yes, I hope we don't miss because we have such a big missile, there's no real reason for us to. Now, in real life, this is an intercontinental ballistic missile, so it should go long ranges. It might be a little bit too long for this map, but I'm really liking the way this thing maneuvers. It's actually very easy to use, which is nice. Usually these big missiles are never the easiest things. All right, so now we're ready to launch, more or less, so I've never done this before, but let's try it. First of all, we gotta put the legs up, so hopefully... yeah, it lifts it right off the ground. Check that out. That is awesome. Next, we gotta do that, which lifts the legs even higher. We are legit off the ground now, so that should keep us stabilized. Obviously, we need to erect the penis missile, so let's do that. No idea in terms of distance how far I should do this. And we are ready to launch. Now, I honestly have no idea how to launch this, so bear with me here. We're doing it! Okay. Well, that was a complete success. Okay, let's hold on here. Hold on. What is going on? Okay, well, at least it didn't blow up and, you know, kill me, but that was, yeah, that was not optimal. All right, maybe we need to go all the way up with it. I honestly have no idea. It is a ballistic missile after all, so that's probably the case. So, whoa. There we go. You know what? Let's try that. That might go straight up in the air and make bad things happen to me. I have no idea. All right, so here we go. There it is. We have launched it in the air. Can I please go to the missile? Yes, indeed I can. Oh my god. Look at this. This is... okay. Little bit too far. All right, so we had to go back to the sandbox map because this missile has a pretty long range on it. Now, unfortunately, there's no... at least I don't think there's a way where you can control it in air, which is weird for an intercontinental missile, but you know what? Beggars can't be choosers. So we're back at the sandbox because we need that map distance. So we're all erected again. We're ready to go. Hopefully, this goes somewhere in the middle. So, oh yeah, we're definitely gonna hit somewhere over there. Ooh, it's actually leaning quite a bit to the right. I was actually aiming for over here, but as you can see, it does... I'm just gonna go over here so we can see the explosion. It does have a little bit of an explosion. Actually, I was hoping for more of an explosion, but still. Maybe it's just the size of the rocket, but I thought it would be like a nuke, because this thing is easily one of the biggest missiles that we've seen in the game. Still really fun to use. We have to hit something, though, so let's try again here. This should be a good shot. Hopefully we hit something. All right, erected once again, and let's let her fly. This time I turned it a little bit to the left because it does seem to, as it goes through the air, lean a bit to the right. Oh, this poor peasant house. This poor peasant house. Okay, we hit quite a few of the houses. That was not the best camera angle, but that's the problem with the cameras. They follow it way too much. Let's go check out the damage, though, if we can ever... I guess we actually have to leave that, because we can't be on a camera. So this is why I don't use cameras, because they are never easy to get a good shot. All right, so there we go. Now we just need to slowly go over there to see the damage that we did, because that camera angle was not the best. But we did take out quite a few of the peasant houses. It's always the poor peasants. This guy, at least, is all right over here. So yeah, that was pretty cool. A very big missile. Not the easiest thing to aim up, but you know what? In typical Russian fashion, it is sheer firepower. And last, but definitely not least, I mean, check out this thing. We got the Dragon's Breath Cannon. This is a double-barreled flintlock cannon that shoots out multiple projectiles. There's supposed to be like 16 projectiles on each side of this cannon. Most of them are on fire too, hence the name Dragon's Breath. Now this thing you aim up just like a cannon, and actually the back you aim with a wheel as well. So I really like this. This is an actual siege weapon in Besiege, which we actually don't see much of anymore. Anyways, let's try out the firepower, see how good it is. Now it is like a shotgun, so I don't think it's going to do a lot of damage, but it's going to have a lot of spread. And spread indeed it did. Okay, so we shot a little bit too high there. We missed the vast majority of the people ahead of me. Let's try that again. This time, all right, so we did take out a few. We took out the door. I gotta slow this thing down though, because I didn't even see any projectiles come out of it, aside from the damage, of course. All right, so let's do this nice and slow and just see what's going on in here. So there we go. We're igniting one side of it. There goes the flintlock on the top. I don't know if you noticed that, but it is a legit flintlock cannon, which is cool. And just a bunch of projectiles come out, actually in not a big spread at all. I thought it'd be a much bigger spread. You know what? Let's back this thing up a bit, because I think that's where the damage is going to be. Obviously, it's not meant to be long range, but we can definitely put some more range on it. So there we go. We're nice and good. Let's speed this up a little bit. Is there an aim? I mean, this is kind of an aim. Oh, yeah, that actually will help us out a lot. So that's going right for the door. Let's see if that's good or not. We're going to slow it down a little bit. Not as much as last time, but enough. And do the left side. There it goes. Oh, that's what we needed. We needed the distance. Look at the amount of damage I did. That was amazing. All right, waste no time. Let's do the other side. I mean, things are already totally broken, but there we go. We added a little bit more to it. That one actually didn't do too much. All right, now we just got to try both sides at the same time. All right, so aim it up. I feel like we do got to lower this a little bit, because it does go ridiculously high. So that should be good right there. We're going to do both sides at the same time. There we go. Oh, man, I think we actually exploded one out sideways. But damn, son, I did not expect that coming out of this cannon, considering it was very, very small projectiles. That was absolutely fantastic. And also, since it is firing rockets, you can also fire it without igniting them. So if you're not using the flintlock, you can do that as well, and it just doesn't ignite the projectiles. Still does a lot of damage, definitely not as much though. All right, but we're gonna wrap up this one here, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of the Best Besiege Creations, checking out the most innovative and unique Besiege creations that I could find for this week in Besiege. As always, guys, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.